Right, hello and welcome back to both of you once again as we go through another Carbonaro effect or two and see if we can't explain them. Or rather, see if we can explain them, I suppose. Anyway, this particular trick is basically Thanksgiving in a can. You can see it says at the top of the screen, see? And in this trick, our friend Michael Carbonaro will produce a Thanksgiving dinner from a can. I mean, in and of itself, doesn't sound terribly exciting when you consider that you can already buy a breakfast in a can. You can get a chicken in a can. So the idea of a Thanksgiving dinner in a can doesn't sound too revolutionary. Anyway, let's see if we can figure out how it's done. We'll watch a bit of the trick and then it goes on for quite a while. So we'll sort of see if we can't explain it halfway through. Here we go.
For you. Here we go. Okay. Yeah, so this is the top layer. All right. Right, because that's going to expand a little bit there. And just as it hits the oxygen, that first layer, it's going to flop itself out there. So that, you know, this is like for Thanksgiving. So, again, just going to kind of cut a little bit. The next layer expands underneath it a little bit, and there's the turkey. So you get both the turkey and the cranberry. And the potatoes are in there too. So.
Okay. How do you? Wait. What's he doing down there?
Whoops. Oh yeah.
Sorry. Yeah. Anyway.
Sorry about that.
There. How do you think it was done? It's very good, isn't it? It's very good. Obviously. I mean, let's just rewind it a little bit. Let's rewind it just a little bit because actually there is a bit of a giveaway. Obviously, we can see that this what appears to be cranberries. Is it cranberry? I think he says cranberries. I don't know, but we're going to use it anyway. So we'll have to pretend now. Let's pretend he says cranberries. Cranberries. There you go. They look a bit like cranberries, don't they, in the cranberry juice. Anyway, if we watch that a little bit again, let's just see what he does with the hand. His right hand. Gosh, we've got to keep an eye on this right hand. We're not going to get to see any of the right handage for the most part, apart from this very sort of particular bit. And it just gives us a clue. Here we go. Get ready. And you could see something was going on with that right hand. We weren't witness to what was going on with the right hand, obviously, because we're watching his reaction. It's fair enough. Let's just give him that. It's fair enough. We don't get to see the right hand action there, but watch. Now, this bit where he's going to produce stuff from the tin is very good, because obviously now what's happened is he's got a whole new tin and in which is a whole new bit of food, and he's going to bash it out as if it was still stuck in the tin. This is an easy trick to do, though, because if you watch, there you go, he's going to do it again anyway. But all you got to do is just watch his little finger, little pinky, as he keeps hold of the, you see, and then lets go of it, you see. So, how's it done? Well, underneath the table, we can clearly see that there is no person there, because we can see right underneath the table. However, we are using this tablecloth, and I do believe that this is the explanation. This is how I think it's done. I believe that there is someone here lying on the table, underneath this table, but on a sort of shelf, if you like, underneath, and then is passing our friend a replacement tin each time he drops his arm down to do whatever. Now, you have to remember that this is a professional magician, if you like. He's very good. And so when he's talking to these people, they're either going to be looking at this or going to be looking directly at our friend, because that's how that works. That's how it is. You're not looking at his right hand. You know, you're looking at the action, which is the food popping out of the tin, and you're looking at his eyes, because he's got beautiful eyes, Michael Carbonaro. Anyway, let's carry on. Let's see if we can spot. Now, the little finger, there we go, watch. Wait for it. There, because we can see the food in the tin. Watch his little finger. Now, can we see it? There, look. See, Actually, he's got two fingers in this because it's probably a bit messy. So he's got his two fingers in the tin whilst he's popping it out on the top there. Then it'll just release it. It'll release his fingers. And that's when the food comes out, you see. Brilliant. And again, there is obviously some point there would have been a swap. And there comes some sweet corn. Brilliant. And there you go. So, I mean, that's how I think it was done. How do you think it was done? Do you think it was done the same way? Or have you got your own theory that you want to share? Well, you can share it in the comments box below and we'll see if you're right. Because maybe you are. Maybe I've just got it completely wrong. And maybe there's a better explanation. Who knows? Who knows? Anyway, let's watch the next one. Okay, here we go again with another amazing trick. But how's it done? Let's watch it. We're going to watch the trick. Let's see if we can't figure out how it's done. Go.
On pencils.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Did they do that?
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, so that's bad for them because the paint won't flake off and everything like that. So the best thing to do is really to take some of the spray and just give it a little spritz. And then it'll make it floppy.
Okay. Now there's a few bits to this trick. How do you think he did that bit of the trick? It's very easy, really. This trick is a trick that me and both of you could both, all of us rather, do. That's right. So we could all do this together, although obviously it would work if we just did it to each other. No. Anyway, how's it done? Let's go back and see. Okay, now if we look at our setup, we've got the spray on the left there, or his right. And we've also got this beer bottle, which is to the right of the spray, or to his left of the spray. And we've got the genuine pencil, which you can see him rat-a-tat-tatting on the countertop. And we will also see this paper bag, which is obviously just lying there. I guess it was just in the way. We could probably do with moving that paper bag. So let's move
so
the paper bag, I suppose. There we go.
Break off and everything like that. So the best thing to do is really to...
And there you go. He's just moved the paper bag and put the pencil directly where the paper bag was. Let's just go back a bit and see. Ready? Oh, that was a shame. I was hoping... There. Oh, well, you get the gist anyway. So underneath this paper bag is our floppy pencil. And all our friend here has to do is when he goes to move the paper bag, he sort of hides this pencil, if you like, underneath the lip of the bag. Because I've got you, it's all, you know, it's all very quick. We don't get to see the, we don't get to see this little bit, but we do get to see.
Right.
Yeah.
Did they do that?
Yeah. Okay.
So yeah, so that's bad for them because the paint won't flake off and everything like that. So the best thing to do is really to take some of the spray.
See, so it's crazy, isn't it? It's very good. But yeah, there you go, that's how that's done. But there is a couple more elements to the trick. Let's watch the little bit.
Just
there
give it a little spritz. And then it'll make it floppy.
Yeah, wow. And so that's that. Now he does do it. He does it again on some other paper. We're going to skip to the bit where, because I don't want to ruin every single bit of the trick. But this bit of the trick's a bit daft, isn't it? There you go. Watch this. So how do you think this bit? So he's nice. He's just been spraying some bits around the counter, say, and accidentally sprayed his hand.
Supposed to do your hand. Wait, hold on, let me get a paper towel. Because it like gets your hand, gets like, oh shoot. Oh boy, okay. All right, hold on.
All right, how did you think that was done? It's daft, isn't it? It's daft, come on. We all know how that, so it's a stupid question. All right, how did you think it was done? Leave your comments in the comments box.